Are you planning a staycation at a Michigan hotel this summer? Could be a good option if you don't want to fly somewhere. But how will the coronavirus impact your stay? Here's what you can expect, plus some deals to be had so you don't waste your money.
Everyone here wears masks and they walk around sanitizing everything several times a day.
Jill Stern's been staying at the Town Place Suites in Commerce Township for weeks, says she looks for a new place to live. She's seen the changes firsthand, from new plexiglass at the front desk to complimentary cleaning products. The closures of amenities like the indoor pool, gym, and hot complimentary breakfast have really bummed her out. But the biggest perk she misses? Housekeeping.
The more people that check in here, we can get our housekeeping back.
So they told you the reason why you don't have housekeeping is because there are not enough people there to pay for housekeeping?
Occupancy, yes.
That's true. According to the GM there, Nash Youssef, he told me with occupancy at about 27%, only one housekeeper has been needed compared to the normal six or so.
As we looked at our reopen date, first and foremost for us was protecting our team.
Mark O'Brien is the GM at Shinola Hotel in Detroit. The luxury boutique has been closed since March 23rd and will remain so until at least June 21st. Plexiglass now encases the front desk and the staff's training with an electrostatic spray gun.
Those really tiny particles get into every space. Then that has to sit or dwell on the surfaces for at least 15 minutes.
A housekeeper then wipes down the surfaces, tapes the minibars shut after cleaning and restocking, and leaves a wellness kit.
It's a little package with masks, gloves, disinfectant wipes, and we even put emergency in there.
This week, the Michigan Restaurant and Lodging Association released a step-by-step guide to reopening with the public safety in mind. Amanda Toy, who handles the hotel and restaurant membership, says at this point, there is no executive order or mandate to have temperature checks for guests.
If a property does choose to do that, that is up to them. However, the majority of places that guests will be visiting, they will not be asked to have a temperature check.
But expect plenty of signage about social distancing, wearing masks, and visiting another time if you're not feeling well.
All right, let's talk deals. Shinola Hotel has some incentives, a special rate for the study queen room, $285 per night, which is $20 to $50 off the regular rate, plus a $99 a night price for the den king room for frontline workers, which includes breakfast for two in your room. Town Place Suites also offers frontline workers a discount, $79 a night plus tax. Regular guests can get a king suite for $99 a night. So really, you just need to call your favorite hotels to see if they have a special right now to try to get their occupancy up. And if you're a frontline worker, definitely take advantage of that. There are a lot of opportunities for a deal out there.